This is a beautiful initiative taken by Godrej Design Lab, promoting young designers to come and showcase their products.
This is the most interesting exhibit in the design section because it's different, it's out of the box, it's new, it's innovative.
You see a lot of the old things repeated time and again, but here one gets a chance to look at people looking at things from a new perspective altogether.
What's interesting about Godrej Design Lab is that they push the boundaries, and pushing boundaries means that you get interesting products, and as a consumer, you can get something new in your house.
It's not really about inspiration, or it kind of objectively comes about from doing some research and then trying to find out what is it that people require and what is useful for them.
For this collection, I worked with resin. The idea here was more or less to capture something in a specific time. So I've named the collection Frozen Motion. So the process of pouring in the ink at the right time to kind of allow the dispersion of the ink was something that was important.
This is a hexagon. A hexagon basically allows for more collaboration than an orthogonal grid, which is rows and columns. And what we've been seeing school furniture to be like. What are the ways in which these things can be interpreted? Two horizontal surfaces, and how can they come together when they're working in a group, when they're doing stuff like craft or storytelling?
Tegi Light was designed to be this kind of simple, elegant light fixture that could serve many purposes and many moods. It was meant to be something that you could read a book under or set a mood for an evening.
Inspiration came about when we were thinking how to integrate time in a very static object. The furniture is formed especially for the particular time that the person is sitting on it, and then once you get up and move away, it becomes formless again.
My concept was to have a big mushroom as a seat. So I submitted a prototype, a small mock-up, and I asked them if I can make it in their factory. So Navroj has given me the opportunity to work there at Godrej Proto Lab. So it has been a wonderful experience working there.
The boy lamp is basically a lamp. It's a very simple product to look at. It is based around is the experience of using the product. So as you can see, the lamp has got an adjustability in terms of its height. It gives you direct lighting from the bottom because it doesn't have any hindrance in the bottom.
Products like this defining how India is going to look at design. This one's really about the future, but there are other products where and designs where we try to work with both the past, the present, and the future. And so that's why I said it's the context proportionate resolution of classic and modern.
I think it's very clever, it's very functional, so form follows function, which is very important.
I like this modular kind of look of furniture that you have here for kids. This is kind of interaction design for me, so I love it.
I would pick on this origami inspired piece of furniture, because not only I think is it interactive, but it also has a lot of fun potential for children.
I think it's a great initiative because it takes the Indian designers to an international level.
The Godrej idea is synonymous to the to furniture.
That seat there, pressed by Deepak Zawar, I really like it. I think it's really innovative, and I would love to try and see how it feels when you sit on it.
Navroz is doing at Godrej Design Lab is a wonderful thing.
For doing this at such a scale of allowing new designs to come up.
What I appreciated was that in spite of none of those questions being answered, they still give you that platform or possibility of engaging within this kind of platform and take that risk.
Working with them gave me a multiple perspective about the finishes, the materials, and how to achieve it.
What Godrej Design Lab helped us is that the proto shop, where we go there and everything is on one floor.
I can't even think of one thing that we haven't got from Godrej, so thank you for that.